I've wondered many times why so many people who are evolutionists, most notably atheists, are so ignorant. Is there an excuse for this ignorance? I see this kind of thing all the time, like this comment that was made recently to me. Neil says, "Sadly, it seems that Christians who deny evolution are really so totally clueless that they must believe they actually need their wisdom teeth, tonsils, appendix, tailbone, third eyelids, and extra useless muscles." This is an example of ignorance. And he calls creationists clueless. Neil, I hope you watch this. You haven't investigated what it is that you're claiming other people are clueless about. Evolutionists claim that these features of human beings, wisdom teeth, tonsils, appendix, whatnot, are leftovers by evolution. They're vestigial. In other words, evolution has eliminated them from, is eliminating them from our anatomy, and we don't need them anymore. They serve no purpose. They're leftovers. But is that really true? Well, wisdom teeth. What are wisdom teeth? Wisdom teeth are teeth that don't normally develop as they should, and they are buried in the gums underneath normal teeth. And they cause problems for people because when they come up, they push between teeth and they push other teeth out of the way. And they're a problem. Well, why do humans have wisdom teeth? Are they a vestigial? Well, in a way they are. They're not vestigial because of evolution, though. They're vestigial because prior to the flood, human beings were much larger than they are today. Our jaws were far larger than we are today. Like every living thing on the planet, before the flood, human beings were bigger than they are today. Just like everything else, the fossil record demonstrates to us that life forms that existed on the Earth were monstrous in size compared to what they are today. And that would have gone for humans as well, because the environment of the Earth was different prior to the flood. The flood screwed it up, and now it's not sufficient for us anymore. And so, in response to this change to the environment, living things are no longer able to develop to the size that they were once before the flood. If you doubt what I'm saying, look up the subject called megafauna. Dragonflies with wingspans of 4 feet, centipedes were 4 feet long, spiders as big as the top of your desk, sloths that weighed 2,000 pounds, the list goes on and on and on. Dogs as big as brown bears. I'm not making this up. This is well known scientifically. Every paleontologist and anthropologist in the world will acknowledge this. So what are wisdom teeth? Well, wisdom teeth exist because human beings had bigger jaws in the past because we were not 5 to 6 feet tall in the past. Human beings were 8 to 10 feet tall in the past. And since our jaws got smaller, they can't accommodate all of our teeth. And so we develop differently now, and wisdom teeth exist. What about tonsils? Are they leftovers from evolution? No, they have a purpose. Tonsils are there to get infected so that you don't get a lung infection or a stomach infection that can kill you. Far better to have your tonsils infected, which can be snatched out with a tool, and spare you from death. Tonsils have a purpose. The appendix. Is it evolutionists claim it's a leftover from evolution? Is that true? Absolutely not. It has two very important functions. One of the functions is that it is a bio lab for your body, where beneficial bacteria are housed, a colony of them, and whenever you get a gastrointestinal infection that causes you to purge yourself and wash yourself out, when you do that, you wash out all the beneficial bacteria that you need in your intestines to properly digest your food and maintain a well-balanced digestive system. That's the reason people talk about probiotics, because it helps to make sure that you've got this beneficial bacteria in your gut. Well, the appendix houses a colony of these beneficial bacteria, and if you get a gastrointestinal infection and purge yourself, the appendix will excrete this colony of bacteria into your gut to reboot the gut and restore it to normalcy. Another important function of the appendix is that it is part of the immune system. Evolutionists used to believe that this was a leftover from evolution, and because of that, in the 1940s, 50s, and so, in 60, even the 60s, doctors would routinely remove the appendix whenever they were doing abdominal surgery because it was there. They were able to get rid of it. They thought it's a leftover because of evolution. Well, it can cause infections. Let's get rid of it, and they would remove it. But that was a bad idea, because the appendix is part of the immune system. During adolescence, the appendix helps to develop the human immune system. If a person has it removed during childhood, their immune system develops inadequately, and they will have a weaker immune system for the rest of their life. It is a part of the immune system. So, is it a leftover? No, absolutely not. It has functions, two important functions. One is it helps to reboot the gut with beneficial bacteria when you get a gastrointestinal infection. And the other is it's part of the immune system, helps to develop your immune system to help you stay healthy for the rest of your life. Tailbone, he says. Human beings don't have a vestigial tailbone. There are 9 muscles that attach to your tailbone, and without those 9 muscles, you would not be able to be an athlete. Because those tail muscles, the tailbone is actually called the coccyx, and those muscles help refine human control over their body, their hips and their legs. Without those muscles attaching to the tailbone, you would not be adequate as an athlete, because you would not be able to fine-tune your movements. You would not be anywhere nearly as agile a human being without those 9 little bitty muscles. They play an important role in helping a human being to add finesse to their bodily movements, so that they can be agile and accurate in their movements. It would be very difficult to be a martial artist or a football player or a basketball player without the tailbone. It also helps control the sphincter muscles. And you would probably defecate on yourself occasionally, at least, if you didn't have these 9 little muscles attaching to it. Is it a leftover? No. It's not a leftover at all. It has important functions. Now, what's called the third eyelid is actually called the nictitating membrane. It's that little triangular-shaped, pink-looking piece of tissue in the corner, inside corner of your eye. You know, where you stick your finger and scrape to remove what's called sleep. When you get up in the morning, you might have some little crusty material in the corner of your eye. This happens to people frequently, and they stick their finger and they rub and they get it out. Well, that little tiny pink triangular piece of tissue in the corner of your eye is called the nictitating membrane. Evolutionists believe that this used to be a full membrane that used to be able to sweep across the eye like a second eyelid that closed horizontally, as well as having one that went vertically, because certain aquatic animals have this. And, of course, they believe that we're relatives to fish that evolved into land-dwelling creatures and walked out on land. The truth is, it has no such function. It never did. It exists because it's a trap for debris that collects in your eye. When you blink your eyes, dust and debris that lights on the surface of your eye gets automatically pushed towards this nictitating membrane. And the nictitating membrane acts like a little trap to catch it, so that you can stick your finger in the corner of your eye and remove the debris. It's not useless at all. Now, they say there are useless muscles in human anatomy, in the forearm, but nobody's actually demonstrated that they are useless. People have tried to show that they are useless, but all they show is that during specific actions of your hand and your forearm, they don't seem to function. But their purpose is more complex than that. The human body is designed to do all kinds of different movements, and these muscles exist for the purpose of coordinating different muscle activities. When you're using most of the muscles in your forearm to do something like twist your hand and pull your arm towards you at the same time, then these muscles will activate, but otherwise they're not used. They're used, like the tailbone muscles, to provide finesse to your movements. Without them, you would be less coordinated during athletic activity. So, Are any of these features actually leftovers from evolution? No, evolution has been disproved. All those features are evidence of design. In fact, everything is evidence of design. There isn't anything about the anatomy of any living thing that is not obviously designed. So why are evolutionists, so many of them today, and atheists so ignorant of this that they actually believe that these features of the human anatomy have no function because they're leftovers? Well, because they don't investigate anything. Evolutionists are usually ignorant by default, by intention, intentionally ignorant, because they don't investigate the explanations for what these things do, and they go off believing because some other atheist said they were useless, they must be useless, and have no need to investigate whether they really are or not. And so this ignorance perpetuates itself. One atheist helps another one to be ignorant like himself.